Good morning, Lionhearts. It is early. My alarm went off at 3:30 a.m. this morning. It's 4:15 now. I already got the shower, got the coffee brewing. That was just Josh shaking his morning shakeout. And I got a full day. I got to work for about the first part of the morning, all the way down in Irvine. I'm going to vlog on my way back. Then I'm probably going to go to sleep and take a nap because, well, tomorrow's the 200th vlog, and the 200th vlog is actually going to start for me today, tonight. You won't see it, but it will start tonight for me at 10:30. So let's get our stuff together, let's get down to Irvine, let's have some fun. Good morning, buddy! I knew as soon as I was over here starting the show, you'd be over here flopping around and stretching and saying hi. Good to see you, Jaw. Hey, Jaw. Give me the cold shoulder. Days with Jordan the Lion starts now. Shake! Not your hand, shake. Look at the crescent moon. Nice. We're working in a theater today. And I loved this. As soon as I walked in, I saw they had all the old movie posters. Weird. Fred and Ginger. All the way down to a Terminator game. There it is. The old Crystal Cathedral. I kind of feel like I wouldn't really be doing this vlog justice if I didn't start by looking in the parking lot where it all started. See, even before I had any interest or any place for religion in my life, I saw a documentary about Robert Schuller and a man who just lived on the method that, or the belief that, if he thought positive, God would create great things. And he started it in the Orange County drive-in. See, when Robert Schuller moved out to California, his family farm had burnt down. And the reason he even got into wanting to be a missionary was because his uncle was a very well-respected man when he was a kid. And his uncle looked at him the first time he met him and said, "You are going to be a minister." So that was his life goal. And while he was attending school, working in the laundry, he came home to visit his family on the farm, and the farm burned down. So he took the very first parish he could get, which was like in a slum of Illinois, and doubled the population of the congregation within a year. And so when he met enough people that believed in his vision, they funded him to bring his Dutch Orthodoxy practices out to California, which nobody really ever had any high hopes of it really catching on. But Robert Schuller just had this positive thing about him. And Robert set out looking for a place to hold his ministry. And the only place, he made a list of 10 places. Nine of the 10 said no. The only one that he could rent was for $10 every Sunday. He could rent the parking lot of the Orange County drive-in. And what he would do is he would set up his mobile station on a trailer, and he would stand on top of the snack bar, and he set out to have a ministry where people could actually sit in their cars, if you could believe it. The people in the town who were of religious faith came up to him and said, "You can't be serious." But what he thought if he could make something that people felt comfortable
being if they didn't feel like they were a sinner, they didn't feel like there was any pressure under them, that they could sit in their car and not have to look at somebody in the eye, and they could listen at will and leave at will, that he thought he might have something, and he did. His congregation grew to where he actually was having two services. He always had the one outside, but then he rented a couple of miles away a cathedral where he would have an indoor service and an outdoor service. He did that for a while, and then one time he got the man who wrote The Power of Positive Thinking to come out and to preach here. And what he did was he told him it was a really great outdoor venue for preaching. Not telling him that it was a parking lot. And so when the man came, and Robert Schuller had posted signs promoting this up and down the highway for 2 weeks up before. In this parking lot, it holds 1,700 cars. That day, 2,000 cars were parked in this parking lot somehow, with a line going all the way down the street, which was a far cry from the very first service. The very first service that Robert Schuller hosted out here. On the very first service, he was smart enough to invite a neighboring choir to come sing. His only request was that every member of the choir drive themselves so that there would at least be somebody in the crowd. And he had 50 cars out here and collected $78. Now, as he got a dream and this power of positive thinking, Robert Schuller actually ended up creating his own. And what it was called was The Power of Possible Thinking. And through this, he hired the most visionary architect in the country to come and help design this. He started with this first pyramid building, but his grand vision was the Crystal Cathedral right here. And it's 10,000 panes of glass, of which they didn't have the money for. They didn't have the money for even the grounds to put this here. But Robert Schuller believed that the power of possible thinking, power of possibility, if he dreamed it up, if God told him that it should happen, that it would happen. And over a year, he somehow managed to raise that money. And what he would do is he would appeal to anyone that came here, and he would appeal to them to donate $500 per pane of glass, and they would have their name etched in the glass. And like I said, as the time would come that he would need each section of the money, he somehow would have the money. And the beauty of this place was that he always wanted to keep it that outdoor feel. So while Robert Schuller hosted the Hour of Power here, and they're actually renovating it now because the Hour of Power is no longer here. He wanted the front of it to still be able to open like a tent. He wanted people to be able to sit in their cars and still be able to come in and feel it. And like I said, what he realized was that in order to really make it happen in California, what he had to do was he had to not preach about the sin, and he had to talk about the positivity. He had to talk about the good things that God could do in your life and would do in your life if you believed that he would. And you know, it's weird that in the 80s there were all the scandals with televangelists. There was the Tammy Faye Baker and Jim Baker and the Jimmy Swagger controversy, and admittedly Robert Schuller did say that overnight they lost 25% of their congregation, their viewers on television, and the money that came in. But there were never any scandals really to hit this church. There was never any wrongdoing that ever came about. And from the time the church started, from the very first service, till Robert Schuller was finished, his wife Arvella was the organist. The organist of a gigantic 10,000 pipe white organ, white oak organ. Even when I didn't live out here, I had read about this and I had also seen a documentary on Robert Schuller, and I just always wanted to see this place. And this place was actually, it was tailor-made for television. He wanted the natural, the reason it was all glass is because he wanted the natural ambiance, the natural light. He believed that everybody feels better and more positive with light shining in, and with the massive choir that he would have in here. At most times, this place would be full of thousands of people for each service. And it, like I said, it was just tailor-made for television. And who did he have run the television side, the production side of the Hour of Power? Why, who's the one person he can trust? Arvella, of course. So now, the Roman Catholic Church has taken over this building. And in some ways, they still want to maintain the beauty of what it is and what it always was and the whole purpose behind creating it, but they've decided to change the entire insides, and that's what they're doing now. I can't get away from this lawnmower. This guy's just chasing me and following me everywhere I go. But look at that. I know that there's, you know, a lot of people that watch my channel that are not religious, and I really don't feel like this is a religious vlog. To me, this is just a masterpiece of positive thinking, belief in a greater good for everyone. That's what it was created for, was so that everyone would feel comfortable being here, and I just love the architecture. Now, there's three massive buildings here, and this was the primary one made by Johnson, famous architect. And as you can see, they've really got a massive complex here. When Robert Schuller bought this property, he bought a majority of it right away for $66,000, he said. And then he said the very last payment that he would make on land as it would become available, he was paying up into like $10 million for the same amount of land. Wow. And right there's where, now the really interesting thing about this place is that there's two 90-foot doors that open up, and that's how the he would still preach to the parking lot. And so you can see there's even parking lot over in there. Two 90-foot doors operated by a motor, and the building is 9 stories high. And it's just, man, it's kind of weird to be here when there's nothing on the inside, none of the pews, nothing's going on, but they've already even moved the, where the stage was a little bit. But wow, I mean, it's just, think of all the episodes. This was at one point the longest running show, longest running religious program on television. I believe it's still on, but being broadcast out of here, it was just incredible. Now, what's strange is that in the documentary I was watching, they wanted this to be the ultimate venue, but one of the things that famous pianist Roger Williams brought up to Robert Schuller was that if the building is going to be made completely of glass, you're going to never be able to control the sound. You're going to have horrible reverberation, and it's never going to work. So Robert Schuller hired the best sound company in the world, and within 2 weeks, this was a Class A venue, almost like a concert hall. Now, I believe this was the very first building built on the property. I believe it's the offices, which would eventually, everything would go into this. Now, like I said, it's called the Christ Cathedral, but I always grew up with it being known as the Crystal Cathedral. If you're wondering just how big this place really is, the property that this church and the three buildings and all the resource centers and everything are, a football field and a half. There's Moses. In case you're not hip to the wardrobe. And I just want to show these little bells under here without getting a big sun glare. Now, later on in the life of this church, Robert Schuller would not only become quite an advisor to just about every president that was in office up until, I believe, Bush. I think I know for sure Clinton was the last one I can recall, but even probably Bush, W. I mean, but he did take a lot of flack for people saying that this wasn't a real church, because what they said was, you're creating a space where people don't have to mingle and they don't have to talk to each other. There's no social environment. There's no, you know, everything that church is supposed to be against. But for people like me who don't generally feel comfortable with a lot of people, I definitely could understand why this would appeal to Californians. And eventually Robert Schuller would stop referring to himself as a Christian. He actually would refer to himself as a follower of Christ. All of these are put here by donors from all over the world. I mean, there's Canada, Britain, California, of course. And this one is one that Robert Schuller lived by. Now, it's a little hard to see up there, but if you look right underneath every single pane of glass, there's a little plaque that has the person's name on it who paid for that.
Yeah, it's a yes.
All in all, the church ended up spending a total of $20 million to have this all completely built and constructed. But this is probably a building that will survive hundreds of years. I mean, at least it was constructed that way. It was constructed so that no earthquake can knock it down. And hopefully the dream of Robert Schuller, though he's no longer here and his parish is no longer here, hopefully it'll live on. And those are the two 90-foot doors right there. Here's the whole other side that I didn't get over to see. I'll just drive by it. They don't even have the fountains or anything going right now. Alright, after an hour of traffic, I made it home to see my little buddy. Hanging out before I get a little bit of rest. It is really windy out here today. Alright, we're walking over to the bank. I want to grab some extra cash for my trip. And he needs to stretch those little legs. Seriously, this wind is about to blow me and Ja away. Blowing my phone right out of my hand. Over here by my bank, they're having the East Hollywood Farmers Market set. This is also where I always hop on the subway, usually. Right, my grown-up responsibilities are officially done. You guys are gonna have so much fun watching tomorrow's vlog. I hope today's was fun. I mean, I enjoyed it. I wanted to see the Crystal Cathedral forever. And what an odd moment that the one time I finally went to see it and it's completely empty, so
it's one of the few times that you'll ever see it without pews and congregations in there. So guys, what I decided I'm going to do is the 200th vlog is going to be split in half. To be honest, I'm going to be doing so much stuff, I don't know that I can squeeze it into one vlog. And since I'm going to be coming back the next day, and I'll probably be worn out, I just decided I'm going to make two vlogs, make one halfway through my day, upload it on a timer, and then I'm going to do the next vlog. And at the end of that first vlog, I'm going to give away these sunglasses, and I'm going to switch over, as long as I don't forget to bring the next pair, and put on the new ones. You know, the interesting thing about this chain and this lock on this outside of this fire station is that they would have only had to put that there if somebody's come over here and goofed around with the wheels and spun the wheels when they weren't supposed to. There's a familiar sign off in the distance. Hollywood. Wow, what do you think that was that somebody tried to bash that window in with? Looks like a baseball bat or a baseball or something.
This is completely ridiculous, Jaw. This is not the way hunting dogs behave. They don't use their owners as a recliner. Unbelievable.
Since I had to wake up so early today, I got almost no sleep. And I was really worried that I would come home from work and sleep. I managed to do all the kind of things that I was like, oh, I probably would never have enough time to do. I got it all done. And now I'm gonna go get one of those healthy burritos. Oh, and I wanted to thank Marty C for becoming my newest Patreon. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. I do love that nobody's ever in here when I come in here because of where it's located. It means I get my food quick. Well, 199 days, guys. Wow. I literally can't believe it. I mean, I don't know how I stuck to it this long. It's a true testament to you. If I didn't have people watching and commenting every day and new people subscribing every day, I don't know that I would have stayed motivated to just keep going. And I'm going to make tomorrow an extra special one. I actually felt like today was a pretty special one. It's almost like a modern marvel that I don't know. For me, when I was there, I looked at it and I almost felt like I couldn't believe I was seeing it. It was just so kind of cool what everything that was involved that went into that, the genius of the architect and just the imagination and everything. So anyway, thanks for watching. Come back tomorrow. I promise you it'll be worth it. And I'm going to call it a night. When you turn on the vlog tomorrow, I'll be somewhere else. From Jordan and Jaw in Hollywood, California, saying good night.